What's up, guys? It's Fabian Irishman, Roger. And this last video I just uploaded, apparently it seems that it did not get any of my audio. So hopefully this one does. I'm assuming it's only because I had earbuds inserted into the phone, right? So, like, it's a possibility that, for whatever reason, this specific phone, this is my new phone, did not find it amusing to have it plugged in and working with a mic, unlike my old phone. Anyways, so hopefully this one works. So basically what I mentioned was, one, Huff basically mentioned that in one of his, it's either his last video or the one before it, basically mentioned that all audio, alright, is what spirits screw with, basically, right? If that's entirely true, then TVs and all radios and any app will work. So for the apps that he all may associate his name with and charge $50 for, everybody got conned on. That's number one. Not to mention his Portal app, which is basically an app. It's just an amplifier. What did I say? Amplifier. Plus, it's attached to, like, reverb or delay, pedal. I don't even remember most of those. I mean, he says he paid, like, $120. That's bullshit. I don't know the brand of it exactly. I can't remember off the top of my head. Most of those you can get for 15 to 60 for sure. All right. Why do I know, Steve-O? Because I play guitar. This is why I know. Anyway, so basically what I'm trying to say here is by his own volition, he's saying that, by his own words, he's saying that, you know, spirits mess with audio on the output to give your ears for the input what's being said. And if that's the case, then why do I need to spend $50 on your crappy app? Just saying. Anyways, my snake story. Okay, somebody mentioned that previously. I didn't mention it. I thought I did, maybe I didn't. In case I didn't, here's the story. Alright guys, so basically here's what it is. I'm 16, 15, 16. I have my mattress on the, and then I have a wall to my feet, a wall to my head, and a wall to my right side, right? The left was the rest of my room. Basically what it felt like is this. You know, here's the wall, here's my feet. That's kind of how it went, right? And it felt like something slithered in between the two, right? That's kind of what it felt like. And I slept back then in the pitch black darkness. So, the first time I felt a little slither-like motion, but I was imagining things. Prior to this event, my water heater went through the bottom base floorboard of the house. It's an older house, suffered some damage. Anyway, so I thought I felt this little slither, and I was like, okay, maybe I'm just imagining things. I'm going to go try back and go to sleep. So I'm trying to go back to sleep, and literally within seconds, 30 seconds-ish, I felt it again. It felt like a slither in between my feet and the wall. At that point, it felt like it was a big motion, and I could really feel something there. And it felt like a snake. So I jumped up, turned on my light. There it is. It's a freaking copperhead. And I yell, snake, you know, and I get my dad. My dad's about 50-something, 60 years old. And let me tell you something, for an old feller, this guy has reflexes like no other. He's literally got a shovel in his hand, right? And as this thing's trying to strike at him, he's like, ding, 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 and he keeps hitting the shovel. It ended up slithering somewhere between the wall and my bed and somewhere down there. I don't know where it went exactly, but it kind of basically vanished. And it was just kind of weird because we never seen or heard from it again. Which, you know, for the next week, like, I didn't even sleep in my bed because it vanished just, you know, it vanished in between my bed and the damn wall somewhere. It was really strange. Anyways, the third thing was about the demonology. Basically, I didn't mention too much more about the demonology yet. And that's mainly because I wanted to show some things. I want to show, like, statistics and reasonings and people's belief systems behind a lot of this stuff, right? in order to do that, so I need to have my editing software to show, you know, these pages, web pages, and things like this, and I can't do that because I'm still waiting on my my charger cord for my computer. So once that's in, I will absolutely do that. Ba-bam! And wow, almost hit my head on that. That was close. And we'll enjoy some more of those, along with some story times, some crazy videos that I've been thinking about, along with the Mandela Effect. We got a part two for that, and ghost hunting don'ts, part two as well. So a lot of cool stuff. Oh, and I'm supposed to travel about 40 miles, 40, 45 miles away from here, and it's a really cool little site. I'm gonna use the SRB1 out there. Along with a whole bunch of other devices, and last time I was there, guys, like, I literally got out of the car and just felt, like, woozy, which is weird, because I'm not, like, a psychic or anything like that, nor will I ever claim to be, but it was weird, like, I don't know, and then it took about 5 minutes for me to get my shit together, I guess, because, you know, and, the group, had already been investigating for a little bit. And I walk over to where the group is, where a specific little graveyard is, back from the 1800s, and I felt a tug, like, on my hip, poof, and I was like, what the, you know, nobody's there, and then we didn't have a lot of tech that we do now, but at the time, we were using, I believe, we were testing out Spud Pickles, his app, Classic Radar, something like that, Ghost Hunting Classic Radar, something along those lines. Some of you know what I'm talking about. Anyways, and right, like, literally right after the tug, I was like, what the fuck? It said dance, you know, and I was like, what? And this specific grave is from a, who knows whose family. It's weird, because it always has, like, fresh flowers and stuff on it, but nobody, even in the town, knows who's family lineage it comes from, so nobody really knows where these fresh flowers keep coming from. And there's, like, a gate around it, and it was from, like, I want to say the 1890s. The story goes is this little girl had passed while they were traveling, and so they bury her alongside this, because it's not a graveyard, so they bury her alongside this bridge. And originally the story went that if you went halfway on this bridge, you turn the car off. I believe I already told this story. When you turn the car off and look behind you, you know, she's there. I had a different experience. Didn't actually see her or anything, but I had a different experience. Basically, with a car, just wouldn't work for a bit. Scared everybody. Anyway, that's where I'll be going shortly. I'm pretty excited about that with my new tech. I wish I had my cameras on, because I have a full spec IR camera that has gone missing at the moment. A little sad about that. But hopefully, maybe I'll take Mary with us or something, and we'll go do that. It'll be very cool. Alright, guys. Happy Turkey Day. And comment below what you're thankful for if you enjoyed to do so. I love you all. I'll see you very shortly. Peace.